Yo, okay, so from the power of you guys got me from 17th place to 5th place, bro. Like, how is this possible? How'd you guys get me from such a high number to a low number? Like, the results definitely came in, yeah, but I appreciate everything. Also, 2,000 subscribers, boys. 2,000 subscribers. What the fuck? Stay in the rest of the video, and there'll be some skating and some more funny moments in here, so go ahead, and thank you guys for watching, and fuck yeah, let's get it.
Only try to run up that.
Yeah, bitch to run up, bro.
This is reminding me of the elevator.
That kickflip felt amazing.
Got William Spence over here doing some crazy shit, bro. You guys fucking crazy.
Alright, so what you guys are about to watch right now, I filmed a couple weeks ago. This guy in the skate park that I saw him skating, I had no clue who he is and never seen him in my life. I actually turned around when I was at the skate park and I saw him on the floor and I went to go help him up and ask him if he needed help. So long story short, the guy ended up shattering his knee at the skate park, so he told me to get the keys of his car, drive him to the skate park and take him to urgent care, so that's what I did.
Hey, let me know if I
We're skating at the skate park right here and the guy got folded and now we're like trying to help him out. I think his leg is like completely fucked. She has a big jump.
I feel like my leg is broken. One of the skater kids right here is helping me out. They helped me get in my car and everything. He's driving me home. Skater life, skater die.
Hey, this is my YouTube channel. You cool with that?
Yeah.
You heard this like whole like kneecap down here.
Got it, Mario.
I think that's his name. I kind of forgot. I feel sad. It's like watching a puppy getting hurt and shit. Like cute little bulldog, you know? Like I got like a close bond with him and shit, so this kind of hurts to watch.
Yeah, you guys are all close and shit.
Talking, like, yeah. We're talking about life and shit. Like,
oh, fuck. Oh. Oh, shit.
Shred on, Mario. Shred.
You guys may be like wondering, hey, how the fuck do I transport this shit? How do you put the rail on your car? Like, easy, bro. Check it. All you do is unclip the sides right here, and it literally slides in right through the car. Like, it doesn't even bother you right here. This is like really easy to transport anywhere you go. You can take it to the skate park, you can take it to the homie's house, you can take it to your mom's house. I don't give a fuck. Just do what you do. But look, I just stuffed it in my trunk, and the pieces all come right here. So I got the legs right here, got a couple of bolts in here, and I will show you guys everything it comes with, so it's gonna be easy assemble. Easy.
No sunsets on a rainy day. You're cuddled up with your baby bag. I'm lonely, been a crazy day.
And just like that, that's how we set it up. But that was like less than like 5 minutes or so. Good and sturdy. This is not gonna roll over. I picked the circle rail because that's like literally my favorite side. I literally do not really like skating the flat square one because it's just not my style really. I don't know.
Circle one personally helps you train for a lot of other things in life because a lot of things in the street most likely will be circle.
Get yourself a transformer rail if you want some easy ass transportation rail. I promise you, this is it. This is a life-changing rail. I recommend it to everybody. Every time I see someone having a flat bar, I'm like, you ever heard of transformer rail? They're like, yeah, actually I have. And I'm like, oh, you should get it. He's like, hi. Sorry, I'm kind of winded, bro. I was skating a little bit low-key because my phone got overheated, but we're chilling. I'm gonna try to skate this, and I want to show you guys a couple of things.
I'm having a hard time skating this because I haven't skated this rail in like a cool minute, but it just collected a bunch of dust during the time, so I'm gonna use my deodorant to actually try to wax it up because I don't have any wax. So
this works as wax.
So this is gonna be the serious part of this video. So I just want to give a quick thank you to you guys for getting me to fifth place in the Braille competition. And also I want to give a huge thank you to you guys for getting me 2,000 subscribers. I did not also think I would hit this so fast. I'm not sure if you guys really know this or not, but when you're coming up as a new YouTuber and you're hitting your first 1,000 subscribers, it's like the hardest thing in the world. It took me 2 years to actually hit that. The fact that like I hit that in like 2 months already and another 1,000 subscribers actually mind blows me so much. I started skateboarding at the age of 9 with my friends that I still film and skate with till this day. If it wasn't for skateboarding, I'd probably be smoking crack right now, honestly. Not saying I do drugs or anything, but I'm just saying like I never really been the type to ever go to school and ever really care about anything else. I never put the effort to do anything but skateboarding. So it's like, if I didn't have this, what would I be doing, you know? My next plan is to actually get a van. And once I get this van, I'm gonna tear the inside out and actually build flooring, a bed in there, some cabinets, everything in there. So everything you guys need in the house is gonna be into this van I got. And that is my next plan. So now that all that stuff's out the way, let's try to get some skateboarding in this video right now.
Night when he look in your eyes, it's like a bright light came from inside. He had the funk, the rhythm, look. Little Calabasas menace, I'm a spear science. The sacred geometry's embedded. Try to tell him where my head is, they just couldn't get it. With your weird pants and your World of Warcraft fetishes, misfits, relentless. You should stay up by the section if you ain't next generation flexing. Y'all niggas arguing on Reddit. I'm flying cars like Coachella trying to get some Tesla credits. Two ahead of them, sitting down the finish line. Don't blow the whistle, just let them run. Misfits in the building, it's like 17 elephants in a room all playing with pendulums and they throwing shade on the can, but baby we get it done and that's a fact.
Whoever sent you this just wants to let you know that you a bitch. You always gonna be a bitch.